After completion of this session, after completion of this session, you should be able to understand the concept of media planning. Media planning. So after completion of this session, you should be able to understand the concept of media planning and the role of media in overall marketing and advertising plan, and also to discuss the consideration relevant to the media selection. So describing the dominant factors in media scheduling. So today's class will have a brief idea about media selection, media planning and media scheduling. So media management involves one of the most crucial dimensions for an advertiser in its objectives to reach effectively the target markets. So the decisions assume further critical importance with the wider availability. So the decisions assume further is the critical importance, the wide availability of media vehicles, and the change in the reading and the viewing usage patterns in buying public. So for instance, markets have been flooded with a large assortment of print media in recent times, and also as well as the television and also the new media. Similarly, a vast spectrum of programs also available on television as a cater for an alternative home audience. So it has to be done outside. So unfamiliar media are now in style. So many media were in the work and style. So these examples include match boxes carrying product advertisements, or the food masala mix, food mixes carrying the marketing messages of good and social causes. For example, here there is one media, Shakti Masala. It's a food mix product, so which carries the good and social causes. Obviously, the advertiser has to seek answers to the following questions. Obviously, so how to spend the defined funds allocated to advertising and promotional activities? How to match the media audience with the market audience for the product or service? How to benefit from seasonal variations mostly prevalent in sales of all goods and services? How to view media with the overall marketing effort? So these are the basic questions where the advertisers want seeks to answer for the following questions. How to spend the funds, and how to match the media audience with the market audience for any product or service, and on how to benefit from seasonal variations mostly prevalent in sales of all goods and service, and how to weave this media with the overall marketing effort. So this module will attempt some answers for these questions. So media as a term can be defined both from the users and suppliers perspective. Media as a term can be defined both from the users and the suppliers' perspective. To the users of media, that is advertisers and audiences. So from users' perspective, it is advertisers and audiences. It is the mix of mediums that carry the advertiser's message and constitute as the vast link between the company and the that manufactures and serves the product, and the customer who buy or might wish to buying it. So this is what the perspective of a user. So for the perspective of a user is, advertiser's message constitute an vast link between the company that manufactures and sells the product and the customer who buy or might wish to buying it. So it's like a marketing communication aimed at wider audiences located at different places. So media suppliers, if you see the term of media from the media suppliers perspective, include the institutions that offer media. To them, it's a mix of service organizations which aim to fulfill the needs of listeners, viewers, and readers for information and entertainment. Are you clear with the two perspective of media, one from the user's point of view and the user's perspective, and the other, the in other hand, it's a media supplier's perspective. In the user's perspective, the advertiser's message is the vast link between the company that manufactures the goods or products with the customer who buy or wish to buy. And from the media supplier's perspective, the media is termed to be a mix of service organizations which aim to fulfill their needs of listeners, their needs for the listeners, viewers, and readers for information and entertainment. You see, the important point to be noted is media are not primarily and purely for carrying the marketing messages. They render a far more meaningful and comprehensive set of beneficial services in which, besides entertainment and information, marketing messages are carried to the audience. So that is the main important thing to be noted is media is not primarily for carrying the marketing messages. Besides entertainment and information, marketing messages are carried to the audience. Naturally, therefore, each medium will do its best for making it more effective, attractive, effective, and closer to its audience. These media themselves have to market to the media users. So the different types of media, advertisers virtually face ocean full of media choices, though many of them may be summarily rejected as being irrelevant, either the product type or customer consumer types. So what are the different types of media? The following are the different types of media where an advertiser or the manufacturer of goods or products can use to market their product. Directory media, we will see the definition later. Of each and every media type. Just here I listed out some of the media types. Directory media, direct mail media, radio advertising, point of purchase media, outdoor media, newspaper, media magazine, transit media, screen media, television media, specialty media. So these are the different types of media outlets available for an advertisers to carry their message. So now we will get into the process of media planning. So like any other planning, media planning is done by specialists who have the necessary amount of training and experiences. Normally media planning answers the following questions: when, which, how much, the timing of the ad publication, the selection of the media, how the coordination in media planning, how much, the budgeting of the ad resources. So thus, media planning is a process of designing a course of action that shows how advertising time and space will be used to contribute to the achievement of marketing objective. In this process, media planner takes into consideration factors like media strategy, tactics, different various media planning models, and the effect of advertising along with procedures for buying media. So media plan is the end product of media planning, and it's similar to a blueprint of advertising programs of a company. To obtain this blueprint, the company must become involved in many activities that are related to the firm's marketing situation. So here the company has to work with the marketing situations of the manufacturer's activity. So here is the scope of a media plan. So media planning activities, it's a process. Three things has to be done: the situation analysis, marketing strategy plans, and creative strategy plan. So the purpose of the situation analysis is to understand the marketing problem. So an analysis made of a company and its competitors, size and share of total market, sales history, costs and profits, distribution practice, methods of selling, use of advertising. So this situation analysis will analyze the first preliminary stage of analysis, which analyze the parts. So the marketing strategy plans. The purpose of the marketing strategy plan is to plan activities which will solve one or more of their marketing problems. Their marketing objectives, product and selling, spending strategy, distribution strategy, which element the elements of marketing mix are used and identify the best marketing segments. So the creative strategy plan, as we said, media planning is a process. These are the process which involve creative strategy plan. In this stage, you have to plan what to communicate through advertisements, including the determination of how product can meet the consumer needs, how product will be positioned to advertisements, copy, creative field, creative requirements, specific objectives of each advertisements, and number and size of advertisements. So with this, all this, considering all these factors are important, and doing base research, then taking into account of all these points, we have to set our media objectives. Before setting our media objectives, the situation analysis, marketing strategy plans, and creative strategy plans has to be considered, and it has to be worked out, and it to set our media objective. So the media objective's purpose is to translate marketing objectives and strategies into goal that media can accomplish. Then after setting up the media objective, you have to translate marketing objectives, translate the marketing objects and to goal media can accomplish. So to determine the media strategy, the media strategy is translating the someone is trying to join. Just a minute. Because of the notification, I could not give permission to these guys. Okay, Ramakrishnan and Arun Prasad have joined. I think they're trying for more than 10-15 minutes. I could not see their notification. That's why. That is the reason. Okay. So as a media setting, before setting up the media objective, the media plan, situation analysis, the creative strategy, the marketing strategy, and the situation analysis plan. So this will help you to, this groundwork will of the product and then from the marketer will help you to come out with a good media plan. So setting media objectives. So at each stage of this planning process, you would recognize the importance of facts and figures and ways to study them in order to take the sub-decisions, the next decision. So the relevance of the information analysis, the base begins in the first stage through till the evaluation stage. So what information is required at each stage will be studied as we go along. So let us study the important stage in the planning process. The first is the setting media objective. Why do we think we need to set objectives at all? Because objectives are the guidelines laying out just what is required of the plan. So objectives answer questions of who the advertising needs to reach, where, when, how many, how often, how long, and in what environment. So this media objective will tell you the answer for all these questions, which is what we call it as setting media objectives. What is the kind of information required? What are the factors which would influence setting media objectives? So by answering these questions, you are essentially in the first stage in the planning process. And there are broadly five elements in a media objective statement. Target audience, the geographic concentration, timing consideration, reach, frequency, creative requirement. So these are the major broadly five elements for media objective statement in a media plan. So let me examine each of the individual element. Target audience, the first target audience. So what is target audience? So identifying whom the communication is aimed at the very first task. So this is identifying, this is done by identifying the persons who are recognized to be major contributors to the brand. For instance, who is the target audience for motorcycle? The motorcycle would most likely be men in the age group of 18 to 40 years and with a monthly income of minimum rupees, at least rupees 8000 and above. So this kind of information, so the target audience, this kind of information which is looked at this stage is product usership data in terms of target audience, demographic and psychographic profile. So the target audience is the demographic and psychographic profile, which tells you the reason. So while the first identifies the person and second identifies his lifestyle or interest, so the target audience is whom you're going to communicate the message or your about your product. The second, the geographic concentration. So a brand sales pattern would differ from market to market. You see, certain markets are higher in priority because of being large and being large volume markets, and some competitive markets are developmental markets. So media objectives need to specify increased weight planned for such markets. So there is a geography, nothing in the market here, I mentioned. So the information looked for this geographic purpose is the performance of the particular geographical area. Some large volume markets, some will be developmental markets. So according to the geographical concentration, the media objectives has to be set. The third one is the timing consideration. So this factor, the timing factor, relates to the relative importance given to the certain time period of a market seasonality, even at a media event at opportunity. For instance, if a campaign is to launch a low interest items, it would be pertinent to build high initial awareness, thereafter providing continuing support to the key consumption period. So it is a launching item, means you have to have a more in the initial awareness, and thereafter not that much pertinence to be given, just to provide the support through the key consumption period. So one of the example is, if any cool drinks or any beverages can take up any event, like media event opportunity, like Lions Cup or any cup, the media event opportunity, and to make its communication, to heighten it, which involved endorsement of the drinking by the particular cricketers. So using that timing, media event opportunity, using that opportunity and launching the product, you can use it. So that is one of the important factor, when to launch. So the timing consideration is one of the important. And the fourth one is the reach frequency. So based on the marketing objective, what is this reach frequency? It is always important to quantify the actual numbers. So there are the physical dimensions of achievement of any plan. The actual number of target person covered is known as reach. And the number of exposures they are to receive is the frequency. So the strategic media planning incorporates setting effective reach or frequency objectives, which are not specifying what portion of the target segment must be reached within the essential minimum frequency. So these things has to be considered. Actual number of target persons is reach, and how often, the number of exposures, which is the frequency, where it has to be an important factor to be considered by fixing of the media objective. And the last one is the creative requirements. The relevant communication characteristics such as the demonstrability, you see, the creative requirement for any product or any message is, there are different type of communication characteristics are there. So you can sell a product, or you can make a market a product by using a demonstration. Some toilet cleaners, they used to demonstrate some this washing machine detergents, powders and all, no, they used to go for a demonstration. Why? No, if you demonstrate the product, no, it will become more authoritative, and they believe, people used to believe. Some visualization, humor or fun in any sense, some visualization characteristics for certain marketing media messages. So visualization in terms of what you say, some acidity or some tablet things. So we have to some drugs, so you have to think of visualization. And for certain thing, sound. So there are various communication characteristics: demonstration, visualization, sound, colors, and creative units. So the creative requirement was one of the important factor before starting up any media plan, while setting up the media objective. So are you clear with the media objectives? The five important elements: target audience, geographic concentration, timing considerations, reach frequency, creative requirements. So these are the important things before starting up any media plan. So the next one is media planning function. So after understanding and doing groundwork of collecting all the five elements and proceeding for a media objective, understanding the concept of media planning, let us see how the media planning fits into the overall media agency in developing the campaigns. So client service, you see, it has to go both parallelly with the creative service and media service. So media planning is therefore is one of the dual functions of the media department. Both planning and buying are closely linked, later essentially concerned with the execution of the media plan. So in the development of an advertising campaign, both creative department and media department works in close interaction. So this flowchart will show you the client service and the creative department and the media service, planning, buying, and so production, that is the creative department, and the what you say, the client service, the media service department has to work parallelly to influence to the decision taken by the buyer. So media selection is highly involved task for a marketer. So after planning these things, now the second factor is the media selection. So media selection, how to select media? The major reason for this involvement that there could be no single best media strategy that would apply to different situations, because the attempts is therefore between media choice and the market preferences. Difference in these approaches will go for a change in the media mixes. So advertisers and marketers in the same industry may be found spending different amount of various media instruments, even though product and markets are the same, because media selection is a Herculean task, because we have a vast number of media to select. So the major consideration here listed out for select media selection, a major consideration in media selection are the left side listed out the various types of media which we discussed in the first slide, and major choice rules for advertising, media coverage, credibility, flexibility, restriction, creativity, and all. So the use selection, media use, depends on the both the types of media and the major choice rules by the marketer or the media agency. So in view of this complexity involved in media selection, a managerial framework will help you to make this easy media selection process. So therefore in media selection is a complex process, because as the choice of rules are available, n number, and the type of media. So this this process deals with a series of questions that need to be answered in the pursuit of media selection. Just answer for these questions and just go ahead with your media to select. So what kind of consumers does the advertisers wish to reach? So that is the first question. So for selecting a media, there are certain questions which will help you for a best media to select. So although it is expected that the marketing plan would make a specific mention of the target consumers, but it still be given a specific interpretation for a creative media strategy. So the objective of the media strategist is to define the kind of consumers that the advertising will reach. What kind of consumers does the advertiser wish to reach? So thus attempts it to find out those media that will reach the target consumers exclusively, largely, or which are efficient too. So it's a role of a media strategist to think of what kind of consumer we want to reach. So one option is the consumer demographics, consumer psychographics, and the product usage. This will help you to decide what kind of consumer to use. So it also outlines the area of data requirement for the media choices. The demographics, psychographics, and product usage details, the data will help you to select the target market choice. So the second question is, what kind of message dispersion is required? After deciding what kind of consumers does the advertisers wish to reach, having all the demographic, psychographic details. The second question, what kind of message dispersion is required? So the important, this is also the important strategic strategy in media selection. Just what kind of message dispersion is, just the message to reach a smaller audience but more frequently, or a bigger audience with less offer. So that is what here they mean it as, the message dispersion. So in normal circumstances, situations, a media selection is based on the consideration that the message should be delivered to many consumers and prospective consumers as possible. So that's what the, what you say, the company used to expect. No, so they want to deliver as many consumers as possible, as many consumers and the prospective consumers as possible. So if a media planner for a toothpaste has to choose between two plants, for example, we are taking an example for a toothpaste, two plants, plants A and plant B, A and B, where plant A consists of 8 primetime television exposures within 4 weeks, delivering one advertising message at least once in 4 weeks to about 70% households. This is plan A. 8 primetime television exposures within 4 weeks. The plan B is 32 afternoon TV exposures at least once in 4 weeks. The choice will be, what will be your choice? The choice A is 8 primetime television exposure within 4 weeks. See, frequently, less of delivering one advertising message at least once in 4 weeks to about 70% of households, or the plan B is 32 afternoon TV exposures at least once in 4 weeks. Obviously, most of the choice will be plan A. Yeah, dispersion is, you see, if you say, if you see statistically, technically, no, the dispersion is the mean, median, mode, standard deviation, variance, these are all the technical terms. What they mean here in dispersion is the frequency. Okay, frequency is one of the distribution, no, how frequently and less often you decide. Okay, what sort of dispersion you want for your advertising message? 8 primetime television exposure or 32 afternoon TV exposure? Obviously, you will choose plan A, the primetime 8 exposures, not the afternoon TV exposures 32 times. So the name of the game is the number of the people reached. However, many research evidence bring a note of caution in the above selection, because we are not, every day they are doing research. This evidence suggests exposure is usually ineffective. The central goal of media selection should be place emphasis on enhancing the frequency of exposure rather than reach. So this is one important point that they come out with the research. The media selection has to place emphasis on enhancing the frequency of exposure rather than reach. So it is believed, because the prime time will help you for more reachability, and the afternoon TV exposure will help you for more frequency of exposure. So it is believed that exposure frequency of 2 within a purchase cycle is quite effective, while increasing the frequency beyond 3 exposures, even though spread out for 4 or even 8 weeks, no, it won't be effective, but a decreasing rate. So there is some studies are there which they are working on this media media frequency. The issue gets further complicated with the introduction of message dispersion advertiser. It is not a matter how much we reach, it is a matter of how the giving emphasis to how many times, how much frequency of exposure. So many media strategies support the pulsing or waving pattern of message release on the ground of cost efficiency. So it strengthens the threshold level of our advertisement. So the frequency, so as you see, the prime time or the frequency of, or how frequent or how less often. Okay, usually the frequency of exposure will work out more. Some research is suggesting. The third question is, what kind of seasonal and a regional concentration is required for advertising. The task of media selection is conditioned by the element of seasonal or regional variation in the media intensity. So it is especially important for those products and services that have seasonal or regional demand. For example, seasonal products, ice creams, soft drinks, air conditions, ceiling fans, and some festive demands for pujas and Christmas, and some even for some textile items for festive demands. So the seasonal regional concentration is one of the important factor to be considered and to answer for a proper best media selection. Subcultures like the lifestyles depends on the seasonal selection. So setting the media in this mode of seasonal concentration is usually easier than the regional concentration. So seasonal and regional demands has to be taken care while selecting a media. And the fourth question is, what attributes should be inherent in a selected media? What attributes? So here they are going for a media must add value to the marketing messages. So this is most important attribute that is inherent in a good media. So the value is both qualitative and quantitative. Quantitative means the media having their own weight to the messages. For example, a particular newspaper is known for its fair editorial content and fair news. No, then the judicial selection of advertisement will appear in just such a newspaper will carry an additional effect. It's given an added effect for the advertising message. The second one is the other option is media is highly, some media is highly inexpensive but can deliver the message only at a broad scale. So here media adds, the attribution or the quality of the media adds value to the products. So it's there are ways in media strategies find solution for this accepting. So the attributes of the media will also plays an important role in selecting the media. So by summarizing the selection pattern of answering the questions, what kind of consumer do you want, psychographic, demographic and characteristics, what kind of message dispersion, the frequency of exposure, what kind of seasonal or regional concentration, seasonal demands and festival demands, I have mentioned some few examples of products, and what attributes, the media attributes. So by having value of the media will add value to our products. So these are the questions to be considered before selecting a media. Next is the media scheduling. After planning, setting media objectives and doing research work, groundwork, and coming to the selection of media, even selection of media answering for many questions, coming to media scheduling, once the media planning and selection is completed to the satisfaction of both the advertisers and the media agencies, now the attention is diverted to the task of deciding the media scheduling. So it concerns answering such questions as how many of each media vehicle space and time units be bought. This scheduling is not just scheduling your message, media message. Over what and time units this will be bought, and over what period should such buying be. So do we want a steady schedule or do we want a pulsed campaign? So concentrating heavily in the beginning and later slowing down. So yes, we want a steady schedule or a pulsed campaign, concentrating in the beginning and later slowing down. So normally media scheduling is considered of a 4-week period in any instance. Thus an advertiser, the following 6 types of schedules are available for scheduling a media plan. There are 6 type of schedules are available. Steady pulse is the easiest types of schedules to prepare. For example, 1 ad per week for 52 weeks or 1 ad per month for 12 months. The preparation like scheduling for this set of media is a steady pulse. Okay, the steady is weekly, monthly ads, 52 weeks or 12 months, just prepare and schedule it. The second one is seasonal pulse. The seasonal nature of products dictate the use of seasonal pulse. As I said, no ice cream, air conditioners, air condition. So the nature of the seasonal nature of the products will dictate the use of seasonal pulse. Example, cold cream, ceiling fans, air conditioners. So this will help in the month of winter and summer respectively. So cold creams will be in the season, winter season, and the ceiling fans and air conditioner will be in the summer season. So that is what the seasonal pulse. So to schedule media, so this is where you are going, the products will decide you take up which type of scheduling you want to do. Period pulse. Scheduling of media at regular intervals but not related to the seasons of the year. It is called the periodic pulse. So for example, as I mentioned in the media selection, no, when you are selecting the media, seasonal or seasonal construction, periodical, that what I say, the festive concentration on season. Okay, here the period pulse is, it is not like putting the media in a regular interval period. So the periodic pulse is media scheduling for consumer durables like festival demands and puja, some food items, processed foods for Christmas festivals or for gifting purpose, so for particular seasons. So the period pulse. And the fourth one is erratic pulse. So when advertising is based at irregular intervals, it is called as erratic pulse. What is this erratic pulse? It's by itself, it's not to be ignored. It's quite likely the advertiser is trying to cause changes in the typical purchase cycles, just trying out ceiling fans and soft drinks during winter. Just so erratic pulse. Advertising in the months other than the summer months could attempt to even out purchase throughout the year. Just an attempt of just changing the typical purchase cycles. The fifth one is the startup pulse. And it is quite common to see a heavily concentrated media selling to open either a new product or a new campaign. So this is what they call it as startup pulse. For instance, scheduling, launching a new product, launching a new brand, a new model. No, so startup pulse where you have to concentrate, heavily concentrated. And the frequency of exposure, you see, when we selected media selection, the frequency exposure will be more for this startup pulse scheduling, the promotional pulse. So this scheduling pattern suits only a particular promotion team of the company. For example, if you take a nature of one time only, advertising will be heavily concentrated during a particular time. For example, promoting what is the eco-friendly or Nexon for this, what you say, concentrating on during this COVID situation or for the Women's Day. So several companies like MRF and even Tata, even they used to launch their vehicle for that particular anniversary. Okay, 10th anniversary, they will be launching that particular vehicle. So it will be concentrated during a particular time only. So that is used for the promotion of that particular event. So that is, even though several scheduling patterns are available with their unique characteristics, it is remembering that scheduling is a part of a media strategy. You decide which types of scheduling pulse you require for your media. So a regular review of the scheduling pattern is beneficial to the advertisers. So with this media scheduling, we'll discuss about the analysis, reach, frequency and continuity. So several research, so that's why this market research and media product research, has been done frequently around the clock, around the year they will be doing to verify and keep on frequently changing their media selection and the media scheduling. So researchers have been conducted on analyzing the data to reach, frequency and continuity. So some of the major findings are listed below, which are found by the media planners, would tell us to remember continuity assumes importance because advertising is often forgotten, if not reinforced by continual exposure. It would thus be unwise for a marketer to spend money 1 week on running an advertisement which is to be followed by another, let's say, after 6 months only. Such long gap, you know, will fail to reinforce the message. So continuity is an important factor, because once if it is forgotten, it is again very difficult to reinforce for the continual exposure. As how, you know, having class, if you miss one or two classes, then it will be difficult, because we are having classes in a weekly basis, the repeated exposure. So these are some of the research findings where the media planners suggesting us to take taking for consideration in reach, frequency and continuity. The repeated exposures are needed to impress a message on the memories of a large product proportion of consumers. So the frequency, how more frequency of exposure will make us to memorize the large proportion. As number of exposures increases, the number of persons who remember it will get increased. So not only this length of time, which they remember also increase. Remembering is a key thing to media planners. So as one of the important marketing strategy, you know, how much turnover that a shop or a company will made on the day is not important. It is important how many have foot came and visited the mall, the shops is important. So that is one of the important, one of the research finding in a marketing thing. Now, how many have visited the shop is more important than how much turnover, because one day they will come. So how much they remember. So remembering is a key thing for any media planner. And an intensive burst of advertising is more likely to cause a large number of people to remember it. So at least for a short time than spreading the campaign uniformly. In many cases, reaching as many people as possible may be as important the task of reaching fewer number of people, but more frequently. That's why this media planning and media scheduling and media selecting and media selection and media scheduling often used to be reviewed frequently according to the trend and according to the pulse of the audience or the viewers or the readers. So that's why any media agency or any media department, they used to work round the clock. If they are fixing a media selection or media schedule for a particular product, the job is not over. It has to be continued throughout the year, and they have to change the strategy. And as a media planner or media strategist, you have to change the pattern very often. Okay, so it goes with the emphasizing the media planning is. Media planning is more an art than a science, because many credible and applied scientific methods have been evolved from this media planning. So it tests the knowledge, perception and skills of any media planner. So in any media management, the role of media planner and media strategist is very important. So as I said, why I am repeating, no, once a product is launched or once a product advertisement is message is done, the job of the media scheduling and selection is not over. Just frequently change on working on reviewing it and taking suggestion from the market research and taking suggestion from the creative media department, and you have to keep on changing and you have to present. So now I'll summarize today's class. So media planning is a decision making process aimed to arrive at three basic decisions: what should be the media objective, which media should be selected, how are the selected media to be used. A media plan evolves from and fully integrated with the marketing, advertising or creative objectives. Evaluating media opportunities is to explore which media are available and what role they could play in the coverage of the target audience. Developing a media strategy entails the describing how precisely the selected media mix would be used in relation to each other with a view to achieve the set media objectives. So media planning and media evaluation is a crucial and important stage to check whether the planned media programs conforms to the objectives, and the evaluation is necessarily qualitative and reach and frequency levels, and fine-tune if need before the plan is implemented, we can review and we can change it. So are you clear with the media plan, media management? And then we, what we have discussed today is about the media planning, selection, and media in media planning, the how to set the media objectives, what are the questions to be answered, and media selection and media scheduling, how to select the media. So with this, I think we can close today's session. That's it for today. Is there any questions?